From the left side of White City, this is Drinks with Mark and Rich. On this week's episode, we welcome back the enchanting and skilled Sedrick Bateman and first-time guest Sonny Dalesandro, plus Facebook feedback and some audience phone calls. And now, play that funky music, Brown Boys, Mark and Rich.
Hey, good morning, good night, good evening.
Yep, your mama.
Thanks for that intro. Tonight we got our return guest, Sedrick Bateman, and first-timer.
The very black Sedrick Bateman.
Don't adjust your sets, ladies and gentlemen.
That's what I look like.
Most of your beards, especially white. Am I still doing good? And then we also have Sonny Dalesandro. You might know him. There's a restaurant. Was the restaurant named for you? You lived there and they built a restaurant around you?
It feels like it.
Like Bugs Bunny. Yeah.
And also recent owner of the Tulsa Athletics. That's our new soccer team.
Beautiful.
Yeah. Yeah, you know, I hope that doesn't start any, like, shit here.
No.
Because I watch the show.
There's no telling what comes out of my mouth. Yeah,
okay. No.
How we get?
I'm a fan of all sports, but I don't want to be like
not too big fan of soccer.
Hooliganized.
Just real quick, I don't know if you guys have ever been on TV or radio, or whatever. But Shaka. this is a reference hand signal. This is our producer Jason Reed actually told us that this is the proper distance. He said, "Learn this distance." And then just get it from there. So this is the proper distance if you ever need to. So this is what you'll see us.
Or if you're measuring penis size.
This this is how it'd be like coming towards your mouth. A dick towards your mouth. Coming right at it. A dick towards your mouth is the proper length for effective microphone work. Remember that, kids.
Does that mean my dick has scabs on it? Because I got some scabby nucks.
It's still proper distance.
Okay. Hooliganized. Right. Hooliganized. Penis.
Right.
I'd like to welcome my man to the show, and welcome Sedrick back. Oosh. Kaboom! Oh
man!
You need an app to clean
that. Oh,
jizz bomb!
I traded somebody a '79 Chevy C10 for this on Craigslist.
Craigslist, you say?
Yep.
That is delicious. That's my first.
It's a delicious Pendleton's.
Busted my hymen with Pendleton.
Mm.
Let her buck.
You said it's from Canadians love it? Or do you mean black people love it? I don't know.
The code for black people.
As far as I'm concerned, I know people that call black people Mondays.
Because nobody likes Mondays.
Because everybody hates Mondays.
I've also heard they're starting to call them canoes because they never tip.
No, that's OSU alumni.
Oh, okay. Sorry, you guys are in trouble.
Okay.
Speaking of sports,
yeah,
we have a phone call.
What?
Or did you have a voicemail?
Oh, I did. I had a voicemail, and I'm gonna try and.
I believe it was sports related.
Yeah, there's a sports related, and it might be directed towards Sonny Dalesandro. I don't know if we were gonna.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen, for taking care of our guests and calling in. Our phone number is 918-373-9120. Call in, leave us voicemails.
Right.
We may call you back sometime. So. I don't know if you want to leave your real number.
I get lonely. I'll just leave the number. I'll call you later.
Yeah.
Are
you on the radio?
This is actually for Sonny, I believe.
Oh, really?
Yes, but this is the first time we'll be hearing this. Okay, you ready?
I'm nervous.
Okay.
Wait, before... Okay, there we go.
I'll still have to press play. We're good.
Well, if I'm too nervous,
Oh, hold on. Ready?
What's the proper etiquette for passing wind on this show?
Because we're in far here, from the mic.
We're in this far because we're in here pretty tight. We're in here pretty tight. I don't want to seem uncouth.
I've actually nobody knows this, but how many episodes do we have? Like six, five, six?
Like close to this may be eight or nine.
I have shit on like two of them, so literally I just shit my pants. Whatever. Are you ready?
I shit his pants sometimes.
Ready for your debut? It sounds important.
Yes, I'd like to hear Sonny talk about how he feels about the first season of the Pulse Athletics and what he feels that will happen in the future.
in the t-shirt?
I think she said in the future.
In the future. Well, I appreciate the enthusiastic question.
That was damn enthusiastic.
I didn't say who it's from.
How do we felt great about it. We were on our tier in the soccer pyramid, to break this down real quick, and I won't spend too much time on soccer.
No, please. we got time to
fill. We welcome all opinions.
There are like
time to fill.
Even when they're wrong.
There's 121 teams, and our attendance was number one out of those 121 teams and number 26 in the United States. So, yeah, we view it as a good start. We're really excited about next year. We've got some really big things in the works, and soccer's worked in Tulsa before. The Tulsa Roughnecks in the late 70s, early 80s. I mean, they were a major sports franchise. The Cosmos had, you know, Pele on their team. And so, I mean, the way we look at it is Tulsa's, and I hate to say this, but probably never going to have a major league sports franchise here. There's not going to be an NFL.
Other than the Shock, my friend?
Well, there is the Shock, whose highlight reel
Skylar Diggins,
is incredible.
Who is going to be on the show in 2 weeks. That's a lie.
She in my house.
Yeah, there's never going to be NFL or NFL or NHL or Major League Baseball or...
Okay, well, that's true.
But really Tulsa still has a shot at a professional soccer team. So,
okay.
Yeah, well, that's the end goal.
Actually, this person called from the future.
And so I can't clearly promise what is or is not going to happen in the future.
In the future? are you refusing to talk about the future?
Well, it's silly to speculate on the future, Rich.
What about, okay, can you speculate on something else? Can you speculate on the,
does it have to do with
future,
the future
of rock and roll?
I can't see into the future.
Nobody can. Nobody except for can. This person who's from the future.
I don't think she said future. I think
can we
she
play,
said,
let's play, can we play the question?
Let's hear it one more time.
Let's hear it again.
Yeah, okay, one more time. I'm pretty sure it's the future.
Everybody vote on what they hear.
Future.
I think it's the t-shirt.
Yes, I'd like to hear Sonny talk about how he feels about the first season of the Pulse Athletics and what he feels that will happen in the t-shirt.
In the t-shirt.
I heard t-shirt too. I think it's because of our new
swag.
Exactly.
They want to buy one of our brand new Drinks
right
with Mark
now.
And Rich.
So what will happen in the t-shirt? Well,
you're watching what's going to happen.
I'm
in the
probably going to get approached by a bunch of interesting people, lovely ladies.
Yeah.
Just want to know what happens in the t-shirt.
Goddamn right about that.
What happens in the t-shirt stays in the t-shirt.
Exactly, and that's a rule.
Who said that? Albert Einstein?
Sure. Einstein.
Okay. Einstein.
You got to say it right or you look dumb.
That's like Sonny Dalesandro. Is that how you say it?
That's, a lot of people say that.
Okay.
We get phone calls for Dale Sanders.
De La Soldro. Yeah, that'd be really cool.
I love that band.
I do love that band.
Oh, it's just me, myself, and I.
Why did everybody get a shirt except for me? I'm just saying.
You got a shirt.
You were holding out for one that had your name on
it.
Are you trying to make a racism?
I was going
to
throw some
the race
card
real
yes,
quick?
I was.
Oh!
Early,
which
too.
Was going to go back to soccer. I didn't get to go to a game this year, but I wanted to know. How many people are black on the team, and how many are from Texas? Those are my main two concerns.
Is that what makes it a sport?
If you're from Texas, it's always a sport.
I mean, how horribly typically should... the black? How many black people? The fast ones.
Okay.
The
most black
ones. Oh, Titty Meat. Titty Meat is black.
Titty Meat.
Titty Meat, black for the team.
Titty Meat, and he's black. He's African black.
He is blue black.
Like Liberian.
Original black.
Papa Smurf, purple black.
Exactly. We were...
You told me, give me the strongest man. You guys go...
I will
and
go
Texas,
to
Texas. Texas, who gives a shit about Texas?
Oh, I think I'm out of here, folks.
Just don't steal anything on your way out. You take last show.
Got, right. Taking that bottle with him.
I'll be taking these with me.
Hennessy this time, ladies and gentlemen. I'm just saying. Sometimes you got to be black to get what you want.
That's how we got him back in the studio.
That's what I tell my children, other people's children. Sometimes you got to be black to get what you want.
It's a Stone song.
Yep. Is it what?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, my favorite one.
Oh, okay. How's it go?
Sometimes you got to be black to get what you want.
Then you
but
this.
Not what you need. You get what you want, blacker. Gonna get it right now. Yeah, pull over. Not gonna pull over. Okay, that's it. That is
beautiful.
Do not let me start.
I do like the idea of Mick throwing a quick little blacker.
Blacker. In the future.
In the future? In the future. The Google... Okay, I just got a question from a person, and they said that the Google subscriber... it's a lovely young lady named Amber Rossman, actually. Sorry, am I still within the prescribed zone here?
Dick length.
Yep, just dick length. And she said... the subscriber was not available, and she said, but I know it's because you really secretly hate people with AIDS, isn't it?
Secretly.
No, we make no secrets. We hate AIDS and people with it. That's not fair. But just they're gross. Anyway.
Back to sports and other sports. Anybody got any football picks? We have another phone call that we were going to go. You guys follow anybody interested in what happened Sunday or Monday? Anything exciting? I think, who did we have?
I have an incredible fantasy football team that overcame great odds, overcame an obstacle called Peyton Manning to win my first game. So I'm 1-0. I'm not saying it's a season, but I'm saying it's a great victory. So there. Thank you, Victor Cruz. You're out there. If you're listening to this,
he is. Subscribe. He called in earlier. He's listening.
What's everybody's early picks?
Super Bowl picks?
You can go. Tell me who you think. Actually, you know what? Honestly, I mean, I know who I think. Who do you guys think is the best team in the NFL right now?
Dallas Cowboys.
No. That's so biased and prejudiced.
Why?
Huh?
Because I'm black.
Yep. There you go. Pretty much.
Okay.
Why is Dallas the best?
Some people might know this. I am Texas born, Texas bred. I cannot go against the Cowboys. My Texasness will not allow me to. So I am only putting good vibes out there for Tony Romo, Jerry Jones, and Jason Garrett. And I believe the Cowboys, the offense is coming together right now. I feel like DeMarco Murray stays healthy. Des Bryant's going to be a beast. He's pushing the X and the O button when he plays. Didn't have a great first game. Defense, 6 turnovers. They're feeling good. Kiffin, new defensive coordinator. I'm feeling it. And plus, all my other teams suck right now. So the sports gods are looking on to me right now. Rangers are losing. Longhorns are losing. I got to do something. You got to give me one thing.
I've got out of the NFC, it's going to be something that flies. It's a bird. It's Falcons. I do buy into this shit that's going on in Philadelphia. It's
Vic look good, man.
It is athletic, and they have athletes. Michael Vick, LeSean McCoy, Deshaun Jackson. I mean, they have the right personnel to put that system into place, but I think the Seahawks are just
like Seahawks?
Nasty.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yeah, their defense, they don't try and knock passes down. They don't try and intercept passes. They try and score touchdowns every time the ball is thrown. And they're the pick six crew. And I could see the Seahawks taking it down.
I'm not trying to jinx my fantasy team, but I really do think at this point San Francisco is the best team in the NFL right now.
I was looking, 49ers was going to be my pick.
So good. And I really do think it's it might be like a Peyton Manning quality for Colin Kaepernick in the sense that he's just making people good. He doesn't have – I mean, Anquan Boldin, good.
He's a beast.
He's good.
He's real good.
But I think working with Kaepernick is making him that much better.
He was great in Arizona, and he was great in Baltimore.
All right. He's okay in Baltimore.
He was good in Baltimore.
He was good in Baltimore.
He helped them win that Super Bowl last year.
He made big plays in Baltimore.
And that's what great players do. They make big plays.
He didn't make great plays. He wasn't a Jerry Rice. He didn't make great plays all the time.
What's the helmet? David Tyree?
Tyree,
he wasn't great.
No, he wasn't great. He made a lucky play. They're done between great plays and one lucky play.
Okay. Mark?
49ers, I have no reason other than new iPhones got announced today. They're built in California, Silicon Valley, close to San Fran, so I'm leaning towards
49ers. iPhones. I hate them.
Super Bowl pick. Fuck you, man.
I hate
BlackBerry ain't going to be a company much longer. So
well, as long as old Black has got them. BlackBerry.
Black in the name.
I didn't say that, but yeah, maybe. Pick 4, I'm going to pick. I think Jinx will beat Union this year.
Great.
That would be a good Super Bowl.
Cowboys. Staying with it.
Yeah.
Yeah. I'll take the Seahawks.
I'll go 49ers every time at this point. Or, you know what? Honestly, it's too early to say Broncos.
I was going to say 49ers, Broncos in the Super Bowl, but Broncos to win. Probably.
I don't know, man. Peyton Manning looks really good.
I like by Mark's logic, it's going to be a Oakland Raiders, San Francisco 49ers Super Bowl because that area is thriving technology-wise.
Telling you.
But they got Troy Smith. He's a Heisman something.
technology communities, that means
it's not choice, man.
In 5 years, Mexico will have a really good NFL team here in a little bit there.
Pryor.
But
Pryor's
I have that little
there.
Funny symbol.
Whatever. Ohio State quarterback,
yeah.
Right?
In the NFL.
Tattoo trouble?
Yes.
Okay.
He sold his jersey. NCAA.
For tattoos.
Gestapo. Sorry. Ooh. I'm not a big fan of
worst.
NCAA.
They're the worst.
So if we've kind of got Super Bowl picks, we'll keep track of this. And viewers, listeners, send us your picks on Facebook. We'll kind of keep track from week to week. We may call you guys, invite other people back, our guests, and keep track of all of our picks up until Super Bowl Sunday, which will be February 2nd. Super Bowl is going to be the first outdoor cold weather Super Bowl in East Rutherford, New Jersey. We're not sure. We're not making any promises. May try to
I'm
have...
making 100% promise. Sorry, one dick length away. I'm making 100% promise. It's 49ers. So
we may try to have a on location, not at the Super Bowl, but an on location out somewhere podcast. And maybe if you pick the right team or pick the score or something, we'll still work it out. We got a long season to go. Maybe you can be on the show with us, get one of these badass T-shirts, and I don't know. We'll do a show maybe somewhere because you ain't coming here for the ball game.
Nope.
We can't have that many people here. We need a bigger spot because we're going to draw a big crowd.
Yeah.
And we need to watch the game and because that's such an event.
I actually don't go to Super Bowl parties.
I know you don't. Why is that?
Because
you went to my Super Bowl party, you fucking liar.
I came at halftime.
Okay. That's still a party. Yeah. It's not like you showed up afterwards.
Well, you had free food, man.
There was free food
and beer.
And drunk bitches.
Yeah. And you know
that's
I love
what
that.
A Super Bowl party
and
is.
And 95% of them
and
were white.
You, okay.
Where are the white women at?
And didn't you played the game show that we had.
And I won.
And you won. Didn't you win like a Blu-ray player?
No, I gave the Blu-ray player away and took the crock pot dipping.
Oh, that's thing. Right. That was a good
idea. It was amazing.
Yeah.
Hello.
How's that working out for you?
Let me just say, cheese and beans at the same time in two different areas.
Yeah.
With a little bit of salsa. That's pretty damn good.
That's good.
I know.
You're looking pretty svelte.
Wow.
You know, what have you been doing different?
What have I been doing different?
Yeah.
Doing no meat this year. I have actually only eaten meat twice. I had some buffalo burgers for 4th of July, and I did
it
for...
Was that the 4th of July? was this... Is that a 4th of July celebration in the future?
Sometimes I speak a little fast. I'm sorry.
The 4th? The 4th? Here's Cedric's top holidays.
Birthdays?
His birthdays. First of all, his birthday. Second of all, the 4th of July, and also Valentine's Day is also very important.
I've been working on that one.
Don't work on it. I don't care.
It.
Please say it forever.
Increase
don't ever
I didn't
stop
say it. I said I've been working. Didn't say it worked.
Yeah. And for God's sake, never stop talking about a treasure cat.
Oh, that's
okay.
Please tell that story. Somebody all tell
right.
that story.
You know. Okay. Tell it. I don't want to even talk about it.
So, Cedric and I were... we're hanging out one day and he's getting really pissed off about something. Oh no, we were drinking and I had something to tell you. Yeah, I know.
It's not the Rich and Cedric I know.
Yeah, what's the difference between hanging out
and
drinking?
I came back and I had a really funny thing I was going to tell him. And he's like, "What are you smiling for?" I was like, "I got something to tell you." He goes, "Man, you I hope so. You over there smiling like a treasure cat." I was like, "What?" He was like, "You smile like a goddamn treasure cat." I was like, "You mean a Cheshire cat?" He was like, "No, what the fuck a Cheshire cat?" I was like, "A treasure cat." I was like, "What do you mean a treasure cat?" He was like, "It's smiling because it found some treasure."
I'm sticking by that story.
It makes sense. I was like, "It's a Cheshire cat. It's from Alice in Wonderland, man."
I know where it's from.
Okay.
And then he made you feel dumb.
Yeah.
Because he was like,
"It's a treasure cat. It found some treasure."
I don't know what the fuck a Cheshire cat.
That didn't make any sense, though. Treasure cat.
Why you gotta correct me in front of people?
I'm on your side.
Thank you.
Thank you.
I mean, I know that you're wrong, but like,
hopefully,
in terms of
hopefully this will be resolved one day.
If you have Cheshire. You have treasure and Cheshire.
I went to
the treasure.
Yes. A treasure. What's a treasure?
Makes no sense to me.
I know.
You smile, treasure like a, cat. You smile like a future cat.
Let's stay on this NFL thing real quick here.
Alrighty. Bruno Mars
what's
playing halftime. That's
super. Yay!
Cool. Yes. I did not know he was that short.
Wow. Did you meet him?
No. He was on NFL Game Day on Fox.
Talking about being on the...
He was literally...
In a tiny chair.
And he had a bunch of tiny guys around him. That was the weird thing. It was like he didn't just come there. It was like 10 people around him, and they were all like 5'4", 5'2". Yeah. And then all the NFL players were just overtowering them. It's like, y'all aren't going to be taller than me if you want to be hanging with me. Got to be a short crew, man.
He's Hawaiian, too, I think.
I want to see his birth certificate. Doesn't make any sense to me.
All right, you were going somewhere with
the all the fumbles right now. Fumbles are killing careers right now. People getting benched all over the place for it.
Yeah, it happens every year.
You think it's just the first of the game? Yeah. The first of the year?
They don't hit as much because they changed the bargaining, the players' bargaining, so they don't have full pads like they used to. So their full pads are basically coming in preseason and in the first game. So the first game, they're getting hit. Oh, this isn't college anymore. I thought y'all were going to hit soft. Oh, sorry, but here's your ball.
Don't they get paid like a bunch to hang on to the ball, though?
Some of them do.
See, I would hang on to it.
You want to.
Yeah.
Use my teeth and shit.
I would.
Exactly. Mike Tyson always said, he goes, everybody's got a plan until you get hit. So when somebody comes down and put that first load on, you're like, I don't really like this ball as much as I used to.
Why'd you hit me?
It was gonna be that hard.
Ow!
That wasn't a preseason hit.
You want to field a question from a listener? All right, Todd Caves actually has he's a longtime friend of the show, and a long-time friend,
first time caller
ever. Yeah. He's so good. Actually, happy birthday, Todd. Also,
happy birthday.
Happy birthday.
Happy birthday, Todd.
And in advance, happy Valentine's Day in the future. Okay, so Todd asks, will the Chip Kelly college offense last all season, or will people figure it out by week 4? Anybody want to?
Oh, I'll jump right on this.
Get it.
I, as a Cowboy fan, I hate the Eagles, so I think it will be figured out by next week.
Yeah, Don Henley's a dude.
Now, is that the spread offense?
It is the, well, it's his read option offense. So okay. It's, I mean, it's still a spread, but it's his read option. You're going to get, what's the name, Hurt, if you keep running him. They'll figure it out.
Get Michael Vick hurt?
Yeah. But this is the thing. With the spread option, Kaepernick did the same spread option last year. So did...
Right. It's the trend. Yeah. But
Kaepernick
right now
proved he can pass. He goes, I don't need to be outside the tackles. I can throw this ball right here behind y'all.
He was
eat
really good
alive
in the pocket, man.
He was eating a lunch.
Mm-hmm.
Do I think Michael Vick can do the same thing?
He's a little older.
Mm-hmm. And not as much wiser.
He hasn't killed a bulldog in a while.
It was pit bulls, so.
Oh, okay, whatever. I don't
know. I love pit bulls, so didn't say that.
What do you have? What's your dog?
He is a Catahoula leopard dog. Beautiful blue eyes. He's a brindle, dark brown and black. He loves me.
Do you have a dog that's real and not made up, too?
He is.
A cat. Oh, what was it?
The treasure cat?
No.
The treasure Catahoula?
He's a Catahoula leopard dog. His name is John Henry. He is amazing.
Okay.
John Henry is a still driving man. He's a great dog.
Okay, so I have another question from a listener. This is coming from Allison Muck. And she said, ask Sonny about his thoughts on people being in more than one fantasy league.
Hmm.
It's total fucking bullshit.
That's blasphemy.
It's like saying I'm from two countries.
That's dual citizenship.
Dual citizenship is amazing. If I was
Texas and Oklahoma,
believe it.
I don't see what's the big deal about being in two.
Well, I mean, you pick your league, and you know it's based on it's an extension of yourself. Your okay. league is like you form a league with your friends or people that you like to just make fun of and make their lives miserable during football season.
I like form with my enemies.
Mm-hmm. That too. I got a guy fired on video from Benny Keith. Yeah, it was great. It was great. And then the guy was like, oh,
do you have that video?
I do. And we'll give it to Jason. Awesome. But the guy after the video was like, oh, you're fucked because that wasn't real and you were whining like a big pussy. But you're not fired. But stop using your work computer for fantasy football. And Sonny got you, and you owe him steak dinner from last week when he crushed you. So, but like, it's important to be have like a cutthroat league, and it gets watered down if you're in two or three leagues. Like I'm in a pay league, and then I'm in my work league. Mm-hmm. And then, don't know you. I mean, do you watch the league?
Oh, yeah.
My stance on how many leagues you should be in is the exact same as theirs. Like, you have your league, although not an 8-man league. Gonna be 10 or more.
Mm-hmm.
Gonna be 10. You in an 8-man league?
I'm in 10-man league.
Good for you.
It's good. I mean,
good for you.
It's very competitive. You still have some options on the waiver wire. I don't know. It's good.
Yeah. 10, you can have a really solid team.
12. I really can't complain. I had first pick this year, so, I mean, I was...
Who'd you go with?
Number one?
Yeah.
Adrian Peterson.
Hmm.
And I think... No?
I just said,
I know. But that's like a black thing saying that's stupid to
me. He's from Texas, so it's okay.
Okay, okay, good.
Play for OU.
Yeah. I know. That's why.
That's why there was no enthusiasm.
He sold his soul.
Me and Sed should do a some kind of bet against each other for who will win OU Texas.
It's called Texas OU. So I don't know what's going on around here, these parts. They always say OU Texas. I'm like, I don't know what game you're talking about there.
What do they call it in Texas?
Texas OU.
Okay, I thought they had some.
We already know.
In the week before, you can go see Prairie View versus Grambling. We also call that the Soul Bowl.
The Soul Bowl.
In Texas, don't they call it There's Always Next Year?
Oh.
Just saying.
Don't they also just call it the State Fair?
Which is amazing.
Turkey Leg Fest.
Baked, fried, everything.
Todd also brings up another good question. He says, what about the penalty handed down to Adamican Sue?
I believe that he should have got fined. I think $100,000 is fine. Yes, he is somewhat of a repeat offender, but
known as the dirtiest man.
Yeah, but I think $100,000 is fine. I don't know. People want it to be more.
I don't know about dollar amounts. It's just that was really flagrant, though. I mean, the play was already down the field.
The guy was gonna score.
Yeah, that's the thing.
I'm with you. I don't think
just rolled right in that guy's knees, man.
I don't think the dollar amount matters.
No.
I think it's punish him with removing him from the field for a little bit. Like, if you're gonna be an asshole and jeopardize other players' careers and livelihoods, you know, $100,000 is okay, no big deal. See you next week. But you know, you start taking him off of the field a little bit.
And sure,
That's penalizing his whole team. It's making I would focus more on the consequences of my actions if I knew I was going to be removed from the field.
I think because it's a newer rule for defense to chop block like that. It's a new, I think it's first year rule.
New rules. I mean,
it's got a bad reputation.
It was way, yeah.
I understand that.
Now, how do you put that up against like a Clay Matthews who did that 3 yards out of bounds on Colin Kaepernick, the Jimmy Snuka clothesline?
It wasn't a flagrant as far as he was going
Rest
to. He wasn't
Jimmy Snuka, I love you.
He wasn't hitting his knees, but I could see how they're not going to fine him. The only reason I could see they would probably fine him is because he said before, we're going to try to hit, we're going to try to hurt.
Oh, Colin. Yeah, there was a big talk about
so that was the big thing.
Yeah.
Premeditated.
Yeah.
That's the only thing. Because I don't see Clay Matthews as a dirty guy. He's never done anything dirty. He just kind of got into the...
This is weird. He just looks dirty. He just appears dirty to me all the time. His hair's always wet.
Yeah.
That's weird.
It's like, did you just get out of the pool?
Yeah.
Where is there a baby pool around the stadium that you're jumping into?
Like, he's walking into a WWE match. His hair is always wet for some reason.
That's weird. Totally off topic. I had
did you just get a message from the future?
I got a message from the future. I had a note here sometime. If what song would you enter the ring to? What song would you play as your background music if you were ever an MMA fighter or WWE? You know you've thought of it. You know how somebody has a song playing while they're walking from the dressing room to the ring.
Mine would be Buck Owens' "Tiger by the Tail." So,
okay. Let's get it on.
That would be badass, honestly.
Let's get it on.
Yeah, I'm gonna have to go the other way. Like maybe something like Leonard Cohen, where everyone was like really like put everyone to sleep, and then you pounce on them. Like
you're gonna go with like "I'm Your Man,"
a little rope a dope.
Maybe like Chelsea Hotel, "Remember You Well," and then you just like, yeah, I choked him out. He was mostly sleeping. It's probably illegal.
See, this is what happens when you have local celebrities on here. I got another question for Sonny Dalesandro.
What does that mean, local celebrity?
Hey, locally, you're a celebrity. Why are you? Oh, maybe you're maybe a national celebrity. I didn't know it.
Right, exactly.
You insulted him, Rich.
We're kind of international. Sorry. Did you not see us in Russia?
Worldwide.
It might be on yours, so you can look it up for reference, but I'm going
to
go ahead and read the question
Welcome
aloud
to the
as well.
D-list.
So this is, I mean, we are we are talking about football. So Tim Dent from across the pond in England, actually. He's an old friend of the show as well. He actually texted us a little question, a football question. Are you ready?
Yes.
And I don't think that he knows that you were on the show or that you were going to be able.
He had no clue.
He's just kind of being a dick and throwing us. I mean, I'm sure it's an honest. He's honestly concerned. This is a real question to him.
And he was well. If he's trying to put this show on the spot,
no,
obviously going to come to the rescue.
Okay,
this show.
Thank you.
No one will be thrown under the bus.
And we did. We had a lot of questions about people saying, "Well, how come you guys haven't mentioned USA versus Mexico, that sort of thing." So let's Tim's question is I'd like to know your thoughts on our back four acting like they'd never met our keeper or each other before, and why we resorted to hoofing the ball up front by passing the midfield and giving the strikers no chance whatsoever yet again, and why is everyone celebrating a draw? It was only Ukraine, for fuck's sake.
Wait, can I answer this question first?
Yeah.
Okay. Put the ball in the goal more than they do, and you win.
Shut it.
Right, and Coach Coach Bateman.
Yeah, secondly, Tim, like, do you really want us to read that question on the show? Okay, if I had to answer it, the reason that they act like they don't know the goalkeepers is because English goalkeepers are historically shit when they play for England. Let's see. David Seaman in the World Cup from Ronaldinho, whipped over his head, far post goal. Paul Robinson, when he whiffs, ball goes in. Let's see. Oh, should we even bring up England-USA in the last World Cup?
Yeah, we should.
When
we
let in the all-time leaker of all time. Just, who was it? Scott?
I know you're talking about the blonde kid.
Carson. No.
That one him?
Yeah. Anyways,
I hate blonde kids anyway.
Don't yeah,
that's cool. Toe-heads.
No blonde kids in this show.
Except for present company excluded over there.
And as far as hoofing the ball forward, I don't know. England are overrated, and they have been for a long time.
Woo!
It's one of the most entertaining leagues in the world to watch because they speak English in England, so you can relate to it far more easily than you could like the Italian or the Spanish speak. But. But yeah, no, England are overrated. They will not win the group. They'll go to the World Cup, though.
Overrated.
For fuck's sake.
Overrated. Oh, that's it.
Beautiful.
Three.
What about USA Mexico? Is it as big a rivalry as everybody says it is?
I think so. Yeah, it's getting there. The U.S., it's scary because, like, 16 years ago, no one even cared about the World Cup. Like, it would have been a shame if the U.S. won a World Cup. We wouldn't have had a parade.
Right.
But now you go to the bar, you know, and
everybody's watching it.
Yeah. I mean, everyone's all keyed up and ready to go.
I think that's where my disdain comes from, was just fresh hype. I have nothing against it. It's just, I think I'm against everybody that's coming out of the woodwork and...
Yeah, I mean,
I just don't like people being happy about things.
Yeah, no, I hear you. And I'm with you there. I'm with you there also. I'm with you there also.
Yeah, I hate when people are happy.
Gold
medal
for hating.
Yep, that's right.
We're so excited! It's something new, and I'm like, fuck
shut
you,
up,
whatever,
dummy.
Man.
Right. Tried out these new burgers? Fuck your burgers.
That was real hate. That was real honest hate.
Fuck your burgers,
man. Fuck you.
I like wraps.
U.S. Mexico, yeah, it's a big rivalry.
Okay, and how long has that rivalry been going on?
Since the beginning of time, and it will last until the future.
Beautiful answer.
They're really terrible. When we play at their stadium, they'll throw things such as urine and cigarettes.
Are you joking?
No, they'll throw shit on you down there at Azteca and where they play their home games. And we're always in the same qualifying group for the World Cup, so we play each other a lot. And I don't know.
I actually played at Azteca Stadium.
Really?
Football.
Really?
College. 94. We played. I went to McMurray out in Abilene, Texas. We were supposed to have a playoff in
Big
Division 2.
Big ups, McMurray.
Big ups, McMurray. Indians. Buffalo Gap. What up? They have a playoffs for Division 2. we were the last team to not make it in. So we got to play the Mexican All-Stars at Azteca. We got to fly down to Mexico City. We put all our stuff in the locker room. It was awesome. All of our stuff got stolen. Shit you not. All of it. All of it was gone.
Oh, my gosh.
Yeah. But still, an amazing trip. Mexico City.
I'm going to put in a call to Tom Olson real quick, if nobody minds. T.O.
There we go.
And then we'll hit Jay Meehan.
Let's give that fool a call.
But definitely, I want to hear Tom Olson's Super Bowl pick here. This is a new. This is like new technology for
us.
Yeah,
this is great. You guys are witnessing history.
Taking calls.
I am excited. Can you hear? Or really drunk. Who? One or the other. It's both.
Both are good.
Both.
No, both is good. Ready? I'm just farting.
There's something wrong with this microphone. It doesn't pronounce TH. It just goes F.
Hello.
Both.
Hello. T.O., can you hear us?
You bet.
Do I need to turn this mic up on this thing? Or? Okay. We good? Can you hear us now?
I can hear you, no problem.
Oh, whoa. Oh, there, we're back. I don't know how to operate this technology. I'm a good-looking face.
We're trying to deal with being in the future.
Can you hear us now?
I can hear you guys just fine.
Yay! Oh. It's a volume, T.O. I didn't know that the phone had a separate volume.
You're doing it wrong, T.O.
Well, when you've had three shots and, five beers, it does kind of...
He said three shots.
That was before we even started talking.
That's way less.
No, I was talking about myself. I wasn't talking about
myself. T.O., how you doing tonight?
I'm fantastic. How are you, gentlemen?
Great.
We're raising a glass to you right now.
We're raising a glass to you right now. This is a shot for T.O.
Since you called in and made me do a shot last week, or 2 weeks ago.
You know it.
T.O., how do you... T.U.? Do you like T.U.? Can I call you T.U.?
You can call me T., whatever. I don't give a
crap. I'm going to call you sexy.
don't tease me.
T.O., real quick here.
All right.
I know you are a little biased on the best teams in the NFL right now, but who would you say actually? I'll give you AFC or NFC. Who do you think is the best team in either league?
I don't know how you can't say the Denver Broncos right now. Mm-hmm. I mean, it's just Peyton Manning is just a machine, and he just has so many weapons. I mean, I don't know how anybody can stop them. I really don't. I mean, they are amazing. It hurts me, but it's
because
you're
Giants.
I'm a Giants fan. So, and who do they play this week?
Yep.
Broncos.
But, Manny versus Manning, right?
Yep, brother versus brother. My dream is for them to be in the Super Bowl in New York, but I just don't think Eli's going to get there. But we'll see. Always have hope. Always have hope.
I sent you that Facebook message because Victor Cruz pretty much saved me. He saved my. I was going up against somebody this week who was taking on Peyton Manning, and they got off to a huge lead. And Victor Cruz was my last. That was the last guy I had playing on Monday, and he fucking ran it up. Oh my god, it was awesome. I won 134-130. It was incredible.
He was a monster.
He
catches everything. Oh, they might have got a bargain when they signed him to that $43 million contract.
Right.
He is, the amazing thing about him is he came out of UMass. Nobody drafted him.
Right.
And how about this? He grew up in Paterson, New Jersey, which is like, I want to say like 10 miles from at the time, the Giants Stadium. And the sad part is he grew up a Cowboys fan.
That is very sad.
And those guys are assholes, right?
Oh, hate them.
Hold up.
Absolutely hate
it. Cedric's on the show, and he's... Question. Huh? I have a football question.
Oh, go for it, please.
To the expert. Does Denver's lack of a running game not worry you at all as far as in the postseason or in the regular season?
No, it will only matter if they have to run the clock out or something to that extent. But he just is able to throw them short little dink passes to the guys up underneath. That it's like a run play. He can just dump it off to the running back or the tight end. He's got what, four wide receivers, and he just got it's unbelievable.
A brand new tight end.
Yeah.
He's got a beautiful. He's got a beautiful tight end.
Beautiful tight end.
It is absolutely amazing.
Edgerrin James is not a running back.
Okay, Edgerrin James was running back, but
he's not around anymore.
Edgerrin James was a great running back with a gold tooth. I know. It was just the shiniest
tooth.
No TH tonight.
About his agent came to him and told him, you know, if you clean up your act, I can get you some more money. And he said, "No, man, I can't be doing that. I got to keep it real."
Right. He passed on the money.
Just like you though, right? You're just like people have been telling you to do, like dress different your whole life, and you just keep it real.
I just keep, I'd be keeping it real.
He was in a Trick Daddy video. Come on.
That's true.
So how much is Cedric drinking the Hennessy today?
He has not touched it. He's actually,
I'm opening it right now.
You know what? He hates being called out, so he's going to bust it. He's been drinking Black Bush. He's Bushmill's Black Bush.
Oh, we had to take the. I forgot the label. I forgot my blackness.
Y'all need to get a bottle of Night Train in there or something like that.
You bring some Night Train, I'm not leaving the house.
A little bottle of Thunderbird.
What's the word?
Tio, real quick here. Let's try and piss. Let's try and piss Cedric off a little more. What do you think the Cowboys' chances are this season?
The Cowboys their defense has improved, mm-hmm. and they've created some turnovers. But when the Giants had the ball for 23 minutes and they gave up 450 yards, they got the ball five times. They took the ball away from them, and with 2 minutes to go in the game, they were about to lose that game.
Cheers.
We'll see.
Drink up.
You're driving him to drink right now.
I don't think the Cowboys will get there. I don't think Romo has it in him.
He got it.
I don't think he'll ever have it in him. And I think that Jerry Jones just meddles too much, and he just won't let let football people do football jobs. Now I don't blame him. If I had his money and I owned a team, I'd be making all the decisions too. But I'm not that smart.
If my TV was that big.
No, I totally agree with the Jerry Jones, though. He's got to let go of the reins a little bit and say, all right, I built this Coliseum for you. I put you guys in a position to win. I've got to get out of the way. And if you need to do this, do that, have those decisions and make them without me being there. Mm-hmm. I know it's hard to say because it's his money.
He looks like a young crypt keeper, though. He's just very,
he does.
Very handsome.
Yeah, the plastic surgery did not go well for him.
Stylish crypt keeper, though. Anyway, T.O., thank you so much for calling in.
T.O.
I really appreciate it.
Love you, man. Gentlemen. And we're going to make this probably regular, so we're going to be bugging you.
And we'll send a shirt out to you here.
Absolutely. I'm in.
All right, have a good night,
absolutely,
man. Thanks a lot.
You guys. Love you. See ya.
Bye. See ya. That was Tom Olson, ladies and gentlemen. Olson. Beautiful. Good call.
God, he's good.
I love hearing some knowledge.
All right. Does everybody want to take a break real quick?
Mm. Really good. Hi, Rich here from Drinks with Mark and Rich podcast. We just want to take a minute to support one of our sponsors here. We do drink a lot on the show. We have a lot of fun, but we need to take a break sometimes, power up, get some food.
Yeah, we got to call a timeout sometimes, maybe sober up or really worry about our health because we want to be here for a long time to entertain you motherfuckers.
Right. We need that energy to entertain you guys. So we go with a real high-protein product. Like today we're having Uncle Chris's Real Cat Meat. And for the money, it's the best product on the market. It is 100% cat meat. Fresh, local. They actually work with local cat growers in the area to bring us the best possible cat meat product there is. You can go find it in your stores. Ask for the one with the cat on the label. So it's very tasty, and you can actually do anything. It's really good. It's very good.
Really, what's in it though?
As far as I know, Mark, it's real. It is cat meat. Yeah, 100% farm raised cat meat right there. It's good stuff. Yeah, we've been enjoying it for this whole time. So,
dude, I thought that was a joke.
No, it's not a joke.
That's fucking cat meat.
Yeah, it's real. It's not. No, don't be a baby. It's just, they wouldn't put up. That's real cat meat. It's really good. It's.
I can't fucking believe this.
There's a season. It's not that bad. I don't know what he's been. Oh, Mark, come back. Oh, try Uncle Chris's. Ask for the one with the cat. Mark. Come back.
Let's everybody do something like really like The View. That's just, you know, a little flyer.
Ooh, can I be Whoopi?
Sure, you're Whoopi. You are...
And just say crazy retarded
Ching Chong
shit.
McDaniels. I don't know what her real name is. You are...
I wanted to be Ching Chong McDaniels.
You're Ching Chong McDaniels. You are now...
How the fuck is that not Whoopi?
Huh? Because he already called it.
I called it first.
Called it, baby.
Dibs.
You're Barbara Walters.
Wawa.
I'm Joy Behart. Is that a real person? Is that a real name? Did I just...
That'll
against it.
That'll work.
Yeah. So I sucked Walter Cronkite's dick.
There yes. you go. Yeah, you did.
I'm Walter Cronkite. You sucked my dick.
You like that? That's a. So actually, we're before we.
Thanks for sticking with us through that.
Thank
break,
you. Yeah. They didn't notice because it's going to be edited out. So
oh, there you go. Okay, yeah. Never mind.
You didn't even notice. Fuck you.
You don't even know.
Care. You don't know what we you do. You don't even here. Know.
I didn't know if they might have seen a cat meat commercial or something.
Oh yeah, that's what it is. Did you enjoy? There's cat meat commercials that
I
they can enjoy.
Love that cat meat commercial.
That is very good.
I saw that.
It's good.
It made me smile.
I'm trying to find this. Okay. Oh, we have a viewer named Michael Schultz who want to know a couple things here. He's a family man, and he wanted to know. He said, I want to hear your take on the amount of massage parlors in Tulsa, along with the amount of escorts in Tulsa. And then he mentioned a little website here, which I don't know if, can we, Jason, can we mention a website? If it's a website?
Mention it, we'll yeah? see first.
TulsaBackpage.com. It's a very common website.
Yes, it is.
And
just got 51 more likes.
You welcome, whores.
BBW.
And I'll tell you what, I understand his concern for massage parlors and whatnot, and you know he's got children now. And but let me be honest.
So should
with you.
You have said his name, or does he not care?
It's on Facebook. I don't know. Okay. Michael
Schultz.
Okay. I like Tulsa Backpage. I frequent it quite often. I've never bought anything on it, but if you are listening to the show, you're watching the show, whatever, Tulsa Backpage is, you can get escorts of all kinds. You can get female escorts. I think I showed Shunny?
That's my name in the future.
Shunny. In the future. Thanks, Pendleton. You can get male escorts. You can get all kinds of escorts at whatever to meet your needs. I love to window shop, man. It's like, you know, like when you were a little kid, mm-hmm. maybe you couldn't afford shoes, mm-hmm. but you just like look. I love looking at whores and what they have to
offer.
It's
like our Sears robot catalog.
Right, whore. Man. It is. I don't want to necessarily, but when you see like, it's just like, it's like shopping on Craigslist or anything else. You see a product, right, allegedly mm-hmm. of what that is, and then you see the price, you know, and you're like, oh, that's a pretty good deal. You know, like I would...
I'd think about it.
Right. If I had...
Not
you know,
going to.
I got 3 hours in, you know, whatever. I could go down to the Capri Motel and hook that up real quick, you know? Or the Caverns in Catoosa.
But they closed that down. I'm just...
Oh,
that's what I heard.
Did. I'm sorry.
That's what people tell me.
So, yeah, Mike Schultz, sorry, baby. I gotta break away from you on that one. I love...
Tulsa Backpage.
Right. And it's a huge thing about, like, human trafficking. And I understand it affects people's lives... But it's nobody I know, so it doesn't affect me personally. So
there you
know.
Go.
Well, that does suck, human trafficking, because some of the hot ones die. So you don't want that.
It's like when we had that brand new giraffe. And it
yeah,
was chip,
yeah, it's better than animal trafficking. Yeah.
Beautiful
God,
giraffe.
Beautiful
see
giraffe.
His neck?
Great
like,
giraffe.
Hot motherfucker.
That was a hot giraffe. I yeah, would have giraffe. Paid upwards of $150 to have sex with that giraffe.
Mm. Oh, easily.
So, yeah, at least. So...
Or at least jumped a fence and raped it.
Yeah. Had a handful of
did you see the horns
citrus
on that thing?
Fruits and maybe a cucumber and brought it over
doesn't
and then just had
it.
Sex with
it.
That lovely giraffe.
Giraffe
so
sex.
I don't see anything wrong with it. Sorry. But massage parlors, that's gross. Sorry. It's disgusting.
It yuck. Is. I agree.
And if you frequent massage parlors, you're disgusting. And I have no sympathy for you, whatever you catch.
I can okay. jerk my own shit.
Yeah, I know how to jerk my dick, lady. Yeah.
With this mind and this right. hand, I can have any bitch I want.
Right.
It's basically.
I know how to touch myself. And you're pretty presumptuous to think that you can charge me $150 for a really crappy shiatsu.
And yeah. $154, what?
I don't know. I've never been to one.
You got coupons and stuff?
I thought of 25 last time.
20?
Cedric, what's one you've been to?
What's the going rate?
I'm kidding. I'm just saying I've heard some people went to them.
What have your friends told you?
I've heard $50 pretty
good.
Okay. Oh, really?
That's not bad. Actually, that would be very relaxing. Yeah, that's not going to.
That's a meager bar tab.
$75 it took you a butt.
Right. And considering the subject matter, we're actually going to put in a call to a local expert on massage parlors, adult theaters.
Fresh local.
He wants to remain anonymous, so we will... Fresh local. We're actually going to... he wants to remain anonymous, so we'll call him J. M. Han.
That's a made-up name.
So, is that Jim McMahon? We call him Chicago.
Jim McMahon.
Jim McMahon.
Outrageousness.
I know. Hey, man. Headbands.
Yep. How did he play all those years with sunglasses on? It was incredible.
He made Oakleys before they were Oakleys.
And on that moped?
Yeah. Is it... Can we hear it? Is it Quali? Yeah. Hello?
Yeah.
Hey, hello. Jay.
There he is.
J. M. Han, how are you, sir?
Hello, Richard. Marcus.
I like how he's protecting your anonymity.
There you go.
I know that you don't have to protect our anonymity. We're fine.
They know who we are.
We know that's perfectly you can say drunk. You can say my full name, right? We're very drunk. It's okay.
You completely interrupted my sexting.
Oh.
Oh. Sorry about that.
Shazam.
I apologize. Do you want me to call back later?
Yeah, thread text.
Nah, it went through.
Okay.
We're okay.
Some lovely 19-year-old girl got a blurry picture of some part of you, so that's fine.
Isn't it?
Yeah, it is. Jay, we were just talking about massage parlors in Tulsa Backpage, which has all the whores on it.
Working girls.
Working girls, that's what you call them. Is there something you wanted to weigh in on? We build you as an expert on this stuff in here in town, so.
Well, when it comes to Backpage,
as well as
NaughtyReviews.com and Ecky.net,
Uh-oh.
Stop talking.
Stop talking, Jay.
Back up.
Hello?
Since TPD crackdown.
Oh, there's been a TPD crackdown. Okay.
On the back pages.
Okay.
It's hard-earned tax dollars going to bust a lot of fine little females.
Oh.
Just working their business, you know?
Are you saying it's more dangerous for me to order from Tulsa Backpage, too, because it could be a cop now?
That is what I'm saying.
Yeah. Oh, shit on a shingle. Mm. Okay.
Actually, it's more dangerous for the females of the species to advertise on Backpage.
Really?
Because Johnny Law, Officer Friendly, as you probably call him, Richard.
Officer Cocksucker, what I call him now. I'll say to his face.
He is probably the guy on the ordering end of that female.
Okay.
And that is my expertise.
Okay. What about adult theaters here in town? Are those still safe?
Oh, well, I originally wanted to talk about the gassing of Syrian civilians.
You wanted to talk about Assad and his gassing?
I wanted to talk about the gassing of Syrian, but now...
Yeah,
I'd like to talk about the gas that I had at the Adult Midtown Theater.
Oh, please do tell.
Oh, it is a fun-filled roller coaster ride of emotion.
Did it kill any Syrians in the theater at the time?
Please say yes.
No, which is why it's good.
As long as no children were hurt in that theater, I'm good.
Were they?
Hmm?
Were they?
You tell me.
I won't tell you.
Did you go on, did you and Jake Crandall go on Daddy and Daughter Day?
Jake Randall.
Oh, excuse me, Jake.
You and Shrake Schrandall.
Did you go on
Jake? Shake Schrandall.
Yes.
And I were, maybe not.
You went on Daddy and Daughter Day at the Midtown Adult Superstore?
Well, I have to ask 20% off, Richard. Oh. What else are you going to do? Marcus, you know about it. Am I right?
How is it under the bus, Marcus?
Well, thank you for joining us this week, and we'll see you next time on
knows what I'm talking about.
This guy knows what I'm talking about.
$50 or under.
50?
That's expensive, man. That's really expensive.
It is. I mean, when you go into the theater, and we're talking the Midtown, which is a lie because it's downtown.
Yeah. True. That is true. It's true.
Marcus, you know,
it's poorly named.
About. Yeah.
It's very hard for me to get an erection there because of how poorly named it is.
Yeah, it just takes your mind.
I know.
You can't.
That's my problem.
Right.
I live in Midtown.
Yeah.
I go to downtown to masturbate.
Exactly, as you should.
And I don't want to go to downtown to masturbate in Midtown. That's a lie.
I go to downtown Tulsa to see Asian men jerking off to black porn. That's what I like. I'm sorry. That's, you know.
That's damn specific.
Where... What day do the Asian men go?
Huh? Tuesday.
What day do the Asian men go?
Tuesday. It's just meet me there. Just call me off the air. Call me. We'll hook it up. They have.
Okay. I have a question for Jay.
It's the Midtown Adult Theater in the heart of the Blue Dome District. Is that a coincidence?
They're not a sponsor. You're pimping them way too much.
Yeah. Quit giving them so much free advertising.
We need money from them before you say.
Hey,
name
Jay. Sonny Dalesandro has a question for you, real quick.
Yes, sir.
Jay, I've really enjoyed this so far, but I have to know one thing. Are you wearing a cape right now? Because everything that comes out sounds like something from a man who would be wearing a cape during this interview. So I need to know, are you capeless, or do you have a cape on right now?
You know what? That's none of your damn business.
and I do apologize. I figured that would probably strike a chord. I figured that would probably strike a chord, but either way.
You want to find out. Mister, you meet me on Asian night at the Midtown Adult Theater.
I'll see you on Cape Night.
All right, hey, thanks a lot, Jay, for calling. We'll talk to you next week, okay?
Have a good night, Marcus. Have a good night, Rick.
Take it easy, man. I'll talk to you later.
Bye bye.
Bye.
Thank you.
Oh shit, that was.
Oh my gosh.
We had another caller. But before we make this call, we got to get into a little segment that we like to do here on this show. A couple different things. One is, we like to, everybody has their own opinion of it, but I think there's some pretty common skank names. All right, get your distance. One dick away. Cedrick, why don't you go ahead and give me, in your opinion, your top three skank names.
Oh, top three skank names. Wow.
And we'll just kind of judge
anything
you.
With Lynn on it?
Oh, that's skanky.
Jamie Lynn, skanky. Mandolin.
Skate Mandolin?
Mandolin.
Mandy Lynn. That's a name, right? I think I've...
It's an instrument played by Mumford & Sons.
There you go.
Oh, who I love to shoot in the face. Screw you, Guthrie. Sorry, put it out there. I know, Oklahoma, you love it and you want to be part of it, and it's really cool, but eat a dick.
Damn straight.
Make a call real quick here.
Okay, make a call.
Yeah.
To and Guthrie? Tell him to stop making
this.
Yes,
I'm calling Guthrie. I want my debit card back.
No worries. Hello?
Angie, how are you doing? Hello? Can you hear me?
She's going to hang up.
Angie?
Angie.
Hello?
Angie.
Yeah, Angie, can you hear me?
Yeah, what's up?
How are you? It's Rich from Drinks with Mark and Rich. How are you?
How's Lollapalooza?
I'm great. We actually had a little gathering tonight. And,
you're going to have to speak really loud, honey.
We were having some drinks tonight and decided to have dinner and listen to Drinks with Mark and Rich.
Oh, that's
damn right you
an
did.
Evening well spent. Thank you. We have do you guys want to, who's all there with you? Why don't you introduce everybody for us?
I have Rocco, Warren, Ferguson, I have Dana, me, and Shauna, and Rhonda, and Jordan Cooper.
Oh.
And some guy that I don't know his name, but he's just hanging out.
Yeah, he's got a wiener, so we brought him.
Cedrick isn't one of those girls your roommate?
Yes, Jordan Cooper is my roommate.
Jordan Cooper is Cedrick's
and she
roommate.
Has no idea that he's here, right?
She found out on Facebook. She should have been working, but she was on Facebook.
Okay.
Yeah, that's how it works out.
Hey, Angie. Yeah.
What's up?
We're actually doing a segment on our show where we talk about the biggest skank names. We want, as a group, I need you to What is that other noise that's going on?
I think it's your voice coming back through there.
Oh, that's where it is. Okay. Mm. Did I get rid of it?
Nope.
I don't know if there's anybody in
there. You want what?
As a group, I'd like you to come up with your top five skank names.
Top five skank names.
Amber. Just get them together.
Amber.
Amber.
Ooh, a big that's crowd was
pretty,
offended there.
That's pretty skanky.
Yeah.
Sarah. I like that. That was the very first one. What's your second
Fast.
One?
Hey. She hung up?
Hello? What's your second one, baby?
Katie.
They're just picking girls.
Hello.
They know.
I know that's they don't like. Oh, I hate that bitch. Oh my God, she asked me for a tampon
until
one time.
Until we get
her
back,
why don't we
do a little bit? What bar they're at?
Okay.
I'm gonna say they're at Fassler.
No, I'm gonna say Arnie's.
Arnie's.
Fassler. No wait.
Right now.
Sound Pony.
Sound Pony.
That's what I was gonna say.
I'm sticking to Fassler.
You're sticking to Fassler. Okay. When they call back, we'll find out what it is for sure.
Here we go.
Sonny, what are your top three skank names?
Well, this one hits pretty close to home because.
I know what's coming.
You're a good person.
Well,
not really.
My mother.
Mm.
Oh, who I love.
She's a lovely person.
She is a lovely person. She's a candy. My mom's a candy.
That's a
It doesn't negate the work she did. I mean, look what
where'd she get that name?
Look what she produced.
Well, no, and here's the thing. It actually feeds in. I've seen what comes next, but it feeds into the next segment. But she's from Kansas, and people from Kansas do nothing but give. They do nothing but give their daughters skank names. My second skank name would be a girl I went to middle school with from Kansas named Starla.
Oh. That is like a classic skank name. That's been a skank name for, I would have to probably say, like in the last 100 to 90 years.
Yeah,
I've
always thought of like a grandma skank
yeah,
name.
That's like,
and chubby.
Right. Chubby. And this girl I knew
Cedric
called
has
chubby.
A nose for chubby yeah. chicks.
I've hooked up with a few Starlas, if you know what I mean.
People ferret a chubby chick out.
I had a buddy named Leroy Peaches. Shout out.
It's to you, Leroy.
Leroy Peaches was his name. He's from Mississippi. Had the best catfish.
Yeah, he is.
He told me.
He worked
me,
at Dave & Buster's, too.
He still works there.
Yeah.
He's the leader of stuffed animals and free gifts.
The leader. The leader.
He's the head, whatever. I don't know. He basically told me, he goes, I think you smell like Hamburger Helper. That's why these girls be talking to you. He told me that. We're in the bar one time, and he told me, he goes, you kind of smell like Hamburger Helper. You need to change cologne. I was like, really? I was like,
what were you wearing?
I don't know. Chef Boyardee? I don't know.
Hamburger Helper, motherfucker.
Yeah,
I just
man.
Said.
You kind of smell, you kind of hungry when they come around you, man. You smell like a wing stop. So, I don't know. It's like, maybe I should spend some more money on this cologne I wear.
You know what? Probably Mandy.
Mandy is
like, I know some Mandys, and I'm sorry to the Mandys that I know.
No,
but like,
exactly.
But it's like, If you're out and you meet a girl and you're at the bar and she's like, hey, I'm Mandy. You're like, hey, I'm fucking golden. and I'm sorry about that, but like, I mean, there's a few move to the front of the line.
Any of the names we mentioned, I think everybody knows these.
Yeah.
You know somebody.
Candy,
and
Mandy. You gotta step
so
back.
So I don't.
And,
I'm not
yeah,
gonna apologize
nothing,
for it, but it's just
nothing personal. You just
right.
gotta step back. We're good.
And even I think these girls probably know themselves that's like
yeah.
I had
they're
a skank's
like,
name
it.
When I was born
yeah.
and I've had to, this is something one of the challenges
that
I've had to
the,
overcome.
That's one of the kind of questions. Do you grow into your name?
Yeah.
If you give your kid a skank's
how do you grow,
name,
how do you grow into a name like Penelope?
Yeah.
That's a skank's name.
Really?
No.
Penelope
really? Is classy.
Yeah.
A classy skank.
Well, yeah.
Penelope. No. Desiree.
I don't even know.
And I was going to say Amanda, but you said Mandy, and that's pretty much, I mean, that's like
that's
a skankier yeah. version of, so I'll have to go, I'm going to throw one out here. Ready? I said Misty, right?
Arizona.
I knew a girl named Wyoming one time.
No,
oh
didn't.
No, it was Laramie. Sorry.
Any girl named Cheyenne. After a state.
Sorry,
or a car.
Cheyenne,
yeah.
but that's a skank's name.
Yeah.
Sorry.
Oh, Mercedes.
Oh,
that's a skank's name.
Now we're going black.
Anything
back on my, you're in my wheelhouse, baby. Lexus, Mercedes.
That's a black skin's name.
Oh, I met Honda Jackson.
Like yeah, Honda Jackson.
She was, hey, you could ride along, but, you know, she wasn't as hot as the other ones.
She had an economic.
Yeah, economic.
Mark, what's it? What, give me some skank names here.
Oh, shit. It's hard. You guys took all the good ones. Mandy.
Rich doesn't even know Candy. Anyone named Penelope. I mean,
it just seems very skanky to me.
I always said it as Penelope.
So I was like, it was something we used to hunt as children. Penelope.
Oh, your mama wanted you to be classy? Well, I'm about to fuck that up. Penelope.
Is there anybody else that wanted to be called? Is Angie the only one that...
I think they better go down in the book for next week.
Yeah.
Because, she texted here. In the rest. Ready?
Yeah,
oh.
Let's hear it.
Okay, so Angie Valiz, I think it was, Shayna Postoak, Jordan Cooper.
Help Tronda. Me
Tronda, Dana Ferguson was on there dick. Probably. Okay. And some fucking hipster dick guy wearing fucking a muscle shirt.
Who I probably will beat up later.
Muscle shirt, mustache, and capri
jeans. I'm not
going to
beat him up because he won't talk shit because I'm black.
So they said, okay, so their picks
but
were.
But he's a fan of the show, so hopefully.
Yes.
Jessica,
you keep watching,
Crystal,
and I won't beat you
and
up.
Heather.
Crystal.
Heather.
Wait,
Crystal
the first
is
one?
Jessica. Jessica.
So she's not hanging out with her.
What was the first one? What was the first one?
I don't know about the first, but Crystal's, that's a skank.
Yeah, Crystal, I give you that one.
I will definitely agree with you.
There was a lot of Crystals in elementary school that I totally wanted to finger bang.
Yeah, but they also sent a list of male skank names.
Uh-oh.
Hey, that's a new one.
If my name's on that list, I'm going down there.
Every male name ever.
Yeah.
Oh, whoa.
Did it just come through? Yeah,
something
I thought that
crazy
was just
happened here.
I thought it was my blackness.
We were on a party line. I was like, yeah, this is weird. What's going on? Okay, so their top male skank names are...
Aaron Adam.
Every I know, you just... Iron Ironson.
Yeah.
Landon.
Ah!
Jason. Weston.
What?
Anything that lasts with un or y. O-N or y. Bradley. Johnny.
Here we go ahead.
Sonny.
Yeah.
Said you and Sed are safe.
Yeah.
They don't know us.
They don't know
dead
none.
Dead air time.
Dead air time. All right, last thing up. Here we go. We've done all our calls. We've done everything we need to do.
Texas.
I like the way he just threw that. You're
that's
drunk.
That's why he checks his mic every time.
I am not drunk.
I know.
Call me some
like,
Bimbleton,
we're like, Sed, check your levels. He's like, Texas. Texas
one. Texas
one.
OU. Texas OU. What? Ooh, it is not OU, Texas.
What can we bet? What can me and you bet on OU, Texas?
This house. And I want the dogs.
And I'll take that dog.
Oh, shit. Okay.
I'm
right
seriously.
Now, what's your least favorite state? Let's start over here.
Florida.
Oh, good one. I hate that state.
I like Florida.
Yeah.
It's got Disney World.
That's about
that's
it.
That's not enough.
That's all I need.
You got simple needs, my friend.
New Mexico. They know why.
Mine's either Kansas or Puerto Rico.
I'm going Utah right now. Because they beat my Longhorns, BYU, you son of a bitches.
Puerto Rico now or Puerto Rico in the future?
In the future.
Now.
No. And in the future.
I love
now
my
and forever.
I love my butter pecan Ricans. Pecan Ricans. Can I have some Pimbleton?
Can I have a little bit of that?
It tastes so good.
I know. I think we're to the point now where we're pretty drunk. We've covered everything we need to cover today.
Huey call.
Thank you so much. Huh?
Huey call. Can we do one Huey call?
Oh, shit.
Shit, if
I
you
guess
can get him on there, that's worth staying on.
We're probably
on
not going to get him on, but we should at least tell the story real quick.
Okay. Before we take this call, or before we make this call.
We're gonna how's the battery beer doing?
Battery's near end.
Oh.
Real quick. Well, you know what? Let's just do it the next one. Okay. We'll have you back on.
One thing I want to say. The last technician you had was a lot better.
But he stole our keyboard.
Yeah, you should have brought more liquor for him.
And
sorry,
I think he stole like one of your, like your daughter's.
He stole one of the dogs.
Like,
I think
he stole a dog and your daughter's like kneeboard or something.
Do you have 10 minutes? Can you do it in 10 minutes?
Yeah, of course.
Okay, go.
Of course.
Okay, real quick. Through a friend of a friend of a friend, we acquired Huey Lewis of Huey Lewis and the News's phone number.
It sort of predates that, though. We had an idea to try and resurrect the career of Huey Lewis.
We did.
A song called It's Hip to Eat Soup.
Yeah, basically taking his song, It's Hip to Be Square, and then we wrote our own lyrics, but with a lot of the world's soups.
A variety of soups.
A variety of soups.
Borscht, minestrone.
I like the way you say minestrone.
Sorry. Minestrone. Forget about them.
I'm going to... Whoa.
There it is again.
Should it be that way?
Yeah. Did I mess it up?
Should it been this way the whole time?
He's fixing it.
It's a black thing.
We have to redo. Damn it, Northside. How did you creep in here?
I told you something sounded weird about my shit like a long time ago.
Okay. I did not. Okay. But I felt that way. All right. But I said, just be happy to be here.
We need like a screenshot of that.
9 minutes. Go.
Okay, go.
All right, so we're going to try and call Huey Lewis, everybody. Wish us luck. What do you want to say to him?
I mean, if we have 9 minutes, then we should probably get into the fact that we tried to resurrect his career through a song called It's Hip to Eat Soup.
When's the last time you saw him? Can you bring that up?
I've never seen
him. You've never seen him?
Well, I mean, I've on it's the album like, cover of the News.
Here we go. Here we go.
I saw him in Mandalay Bay. He was awesome, and I love Carla.
Have you called him before?
No, I've never
We're
called
calling
him.
Huey Lewis.
Oh, my God. This is going down.
Hello?
Hi, Huey?
Hello?
Hey, sorry to bother you, Huey. You all right?
Hello?
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 Huey?
Huey, it's Sonny.
Who?
Sonny. I can't hear you very well. What's wrong with your phone?
Sonny?
Is this the Arabic, Huey Lewis? Huey, we want to make a video on YouTube called It's Hip to Eat Soup. Yeah, are you on board or not?
Let's just get this right out there. Huey, we have a song called It's Hip to Eat Soup. It's kind of a send-up of your song. It's hip to be square. We want to do it. Are you in? Just say yes or no. Oh!
He hung up on us.
That's a yes, right?
Talk to the phone. We were talking to him.
I was holding it to each of them.
Oh,
that
Lewis.
Is a yes, though.
Yeah, that's a yes. So look for that.
I still love you, Huey.
Look for our song coming up called It's Hip to Eat Soup. It's going to be right next to probably 2 Chainz's new album.
Yeah, look further. Look for next year's Super Bowl.
Cedrick was telling us.
We'll be on the halftime. You're welcome.
Where you can get a cookbook.
Yeah.
The new 2 Chainz.
When you buy the new 2 Chainz album, when did it just come out?
Today.
You also get a very detailed cookbook. I don't know if you guys knew that about 2 Chainz.
It's pretty good, actually.
One album. One book.
2 Chainz.
Oh, I gotta call here. I think we're good here.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen, for joining us tonight. Go to drinkswithmarkandrich.com. Like us on Facebook. Subscribe to us on iTunes. Subscribe to us on YouTube. Call, leave us a voicemail, 918-373-9120. I'm so spitty. Can you feel that?
Buy shirts.
Mom and daddy, get internet. I'm on TV.
Hit us up. Buy some shirts. We got swag for sale.
Please.
Be sure to visit Sedrick Bateman on Thursdays at Empire Bar, and the rest of the week you can find him at our bar in beautiful Brookside. You can catch Sonny Dalesandro at Dalesandro's Tuesday through Saturday. Want to be part of the show? Have a topic you want discussed? Leave us a voicemail with your comments or suggestions at 918-373-9120. Join the conversation at www.drinkswithmarkandrich.com. And remember, like us on Facebook and subscribe to us on iTunes.